Okay, guys, first things first. I had originally planned to do a review for Rocky Horror Picture Show. Hello, Dolly, and Kiss Me, Kate. The original plan got scrapped because I watched Hello, Dolly, Kiss Me, Kate, and just, ugh. My God, not worth it, not worth the time, not worth the energy. Ugh. Both of them were just bombs in my eyes, but so instead of doing a threefer, I'm just gonna do Rocky Horror. It's the only one of the three that I had left to watch that was really worthy of it. So with that said, I'm gonna go ahead and this is the review for the 40th anniversary edition Blu-ray of Rocky Horror Picture Show. Now, before I get into the actual review, which I'm not going to go into what happens or anything like that, because I feel like it's one of those things that everybody has seen 10 million times. That's why it's got a cult following that it does. But before I even get into this, I just want to say I have seen this before. It had been a minute. I don't know, like, years or something like that, but I have seen it before. And it's funny when I think about this one because, when Becca and Jen and Josh and I went to Walmart that night and it was in the 78 bin. And Jen asked me if I had seen it, and I delayed answering because I had to think back because I watched so many movies. But it's funny because I thought in the time that I was thinking back, she was gonna have a heart attack because then when I finally said yes, she was like, okay, good. I was gonna have to kill you. My life is not gonna end because of a movie. So there's kind of a memory tied to that one that's just awesome for me. Something's going on because I can hear it's either an ambulance or a cop car. So she's going on somewhere. Anyway. Rocky Horror. This is one of the best musicals I've ever seen. The songs are kick-ass. The way it was shot was kick-ass. All of the actors did a fantastic job. And the thing I liked about the special edition Blu-ray that I got, other than the price, because it was freaking cheaper at Amazon than it was at Walmart that night, I think. And was the fact that things loaded with special features. It had a sing-along thing. It had a which. I've never done that in my life, so whatever, that didn't apply to me. It had like retrospectives coming out the ass. This almost to me felt like a Shoutback release. There's so much extra stuff to go with it. Not going to expound too much, like I said, on the virtues of the movie, because I feel like everybody's seen it It's been, I've seen a bunch of reviews on YouTube for it, so what the hell is, one more. To add to the millions of reviews I've seen on this thing on YouTube, so. But yeah, enjoyed it. I thought it was really well acted out, really well shot. Actually, because I hadn't seen it in like 10 years, and that's a guesstimate on my part, when I got it, that, or I thought when I first was interested in getting it, that it was longer than it actually was, but it's only 1 hour and 40 minutes. So the pacing was really good, was really well done, and the songs were awesome. Like I said, I skipped the sing-along part of it, because that's just dumb to me. Well, not singing along to songs, I've done that before, but like having a special feature that actually allows you to like do that, I guess, like in the middle of the movie, like when a song comes on, it takes the like puts the lyrics on the screen, and my OCD ass is really kind of anal about that. I don't like subtitles or anything impinging upon my viewing experience. So, for me, still one of the best musicals I've ever seen. The only thing, and this really is a negative towards the movie itself, I guess it's on me, but the only thing that they haven't done is I haven't seen the actual stage show, which, I had an ex that kind of wanted me to go do it like a few years back, but before we could, things fell apart and we're obviously not together now. So that's the one thing in this whole Rocky Horror experience that I am missing. But yeah, so I don't need to expound upon like the goodness of this movie, like I said. So just know that it's a good movie. It's well worth picking up if you can find it. And even in some cases, because it's got such a cult following, if you can't find it really cheap, it's, I would have paid $35 for it. Just because it's earned that. It's earned the right to be one of those movies that I don't care what the fucking price it is, I'll pay it. So I'm gonna go ahead and give it 5 reviews out of 5. Tell you to watch it if you haven't. If you have and you haven't seen in a while, it's worth getting out and rewatching and killing, an hour and 40 minutes if you can. With that said, I'm gonna tell you all that I love you, and thanks for fostering the creativity. And sorry this wasn't 3D, but the other two just didn't meet my lofty expectations to be review worthy. So and for this one, I know it really wasn't a review per se, but again, what more can you say about a movie that's this good that hasn't already been said? So I love you guys. Thank you for listening to this, watching this, and fostering creativity. Peace.